Hi students, so I'm going to take up a speed solution of 16th March evening shift. The purpose is to quickly revise the whole syllabus from the point of view of exam within a very short period of time. और यहाँ पे मैं सिर्फ इतना चाहूंगा कि इन सारे questions के quick short notes बना लीजिए, क्योंकि अगर papers की benchmarking same रहती है तो these questions and the quick solutions are going to be helpful for you. और सबसे बड़ा purpose speed solution का ये है कि आप confidence को build कीजिए कि इससे ज़्यादा speed से आप solve कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि questions बहुत fundamental है. More than 80-85% questions are directly from NCERT and PYQs. So let's start with the 16th March evening shift. Thank you, Bhoji. So student, in this question it says two identical antennas are mounted on identical towers and are separated from each other by a distance of 45 kilometers. और हमको इनके बीच का distance निकालना है, so that it is saying what should be nearly the minimum height of antenna so as to receive the signal in line of sight. So direct formula we are going to use. If yahan pe given hai height of transmitting antenna is equals to height of receiving antenna is equals to h. This implies yahan pe hum d ko lete hain, root of 2r height of transmitting antenna plus root of 2r height of receiving antenna. So this will become d is equals to 2 root 2 r h. Aur yahan pe humko h ka value nikalna hai. So h is given as d square by 8 r. Value substitute karein, this 45 square multiplied by 10 to power 6 divided by 8 times 6.4 into 10 to power 6. This gets cancelled out. I'm leaving simple calculation on you. This exactly gives you the value 39.55 meters. So answer to this question will opt as answer option A. Bhoji, aage padhe. Thank you, Bhoji. So student, in this question it says de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron and a proton were calculated by accelerating at a potential difference of 100 volt. So we need to calculate the ratio of wavelength. So direct question, we don't need to do anything. De Broglie wavelength can be directly given as h over root of 2mqv for any particle with charge q mass m accelerated with a voltage v. So yahan pe lambda of electron by lambda of proton nikalna hai. Everything is same. You calculate this, gives you root of mass of proton by mass of electron. So this gives root of 1.00727 by 0.00055. Simplifying calculation part, I am leaving. This comes out to be 42.79. So the closest match is with answer option A. That's the correct option for this question. Thank you, Bhoji. So student, there's a question of damped oscillation where it is saying in a spring mass system for damped SHM, mass given a decay constant given a, we are required to calculate the time after which the amplitude drops to half the initial value. So we can write for damped oscillation here, we know amplitude can be given as a naught e to power minus bt by 2m. So in this case a is equals to a naught by 2, so time we need to calculate. So taking log, it gives ln 2 is equals to bt by 2m. So yahan pe hamare paas directly time aa gaya 2m by b ln 2. So numerical value we can substitute, mass is 0.5, b is 0.02 and ln 2 is 0.693. So here this 1, this is 69.3 divided by 2 comes out to be 34.65 second. That matches with answer option B in this question. So Bhoji, clear karein. Thank you, Bhoji. So students, again there's a theoretical question for a bimetallic strip jisme AB do metals given hai aur question mein pucha gaya hai. A का जो कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्सपेंशन है वो B से ज़्यादा है, तो अगर बायोमेटेलिक स्ट्रिप को कोल्ड बाथ में डालते हैं देन व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन. सो यू नो वेल कि A ज़्यादा कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हो जाएगी कोल्ड बाथ में. सो इफ A विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेस, B विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, A विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मोर एंड B विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेस, तो सिचुएशन वुड बी लाइक दिस. सो ये A है, ये B है, तो बेंडिंग विल बी टूवर्ड A. सो डायरेक्टली वी कैन राइट आंसर ऑप्शन वुड बी इन दिस केस A इज द करेक्ट आंसर, इट विल बी टूवर्ड लेफ्ट. Thank you, Bhoji. So student, there's a basic question of momentum conservation and energy conservation. Here it says a large block of wood of mass 5.99 kilogram is hanging from two long massless cords and a bullet of mass 10 gram, that is 0.01 kilogram, is fired onto the block and gets embedded into it. So values dekh ke pata chal raha hai momentum conservation mein dono jab add honge to 6 kg ho jayega, some loving value is going to be there. When this bullet plus block system swing upward, it rises up to a height of 9.8 centimeters. So we need to calculate the speed of bullet. So yahan solution mein main directly likh sakta hoon by conservation of momentum. So here I can write initial bullet, which is of mass 0.01 kilogram, is moving with the velocity v, and after collision, the mass becomes 6 kilogram, and final velocity becomes, obviously, after collision, if its velocity is v1, I can write as root 2 gh. So this I can write as root of 2 into 9.8 into height is also given to us as 9.8 into 10 to the power minus 2. Simplifying, I'm getting the value of v, which is 6 into root 2 is 1.414. 9.8 square root is 9.8 into 10 to the power minus 2 root is 0.1 divided by 0.01. Again, simple calculation is there. I'm leaving this calculation part. Solving this comes out to be 831.4 meters per second. So answer matches with option C. Simple calculation hai, but you need to be fast enough in analyzing. Bahut fast question solve ho jate hain. Thank you, Boji. Student, again, a basic question of vectors, or you can call it also a question of kinematics, where it says mosquito is having moving with a velocity given by this function. Accelerating under uniform condition, we are required to check the direction of mosquito after 2 seconds. So, yahan pe at t equals to 2 seconds, we can check the velocity vector is given as 0.5 multiplied by 4, this 2 i cap plus the 6 j cap plus 9 k cap. So, as we are having the velocity vector, unit vector of velocity, we can write 2 i cap plus 6 j cap plus 9 k cap divided by under root of 4 plus 36 plus 81 is root 121. This is 1 by 11 times 2 i cap plus 6 j cap plus 9 k cap. So this is the velocity vector. So theta from x axis, we need to check from x and y axis. Theta from x axis comes out to be cos inverse of v cap dot I cap. This is cos inverse of 2 by 11. So if we check it with the 10 inverse, so 10 inverse, this will be 2 by 11. If you just calculate with the triangle, theta is this 2, 11, this 121 minus 4, this root of 117. This 10 inverse of root of 117 by 2. Similarly, theta from y-axis will be cos inverse of v cap dot j cap. So we calculate this cos inverse of 6 by 11. If we calculate in 10 tangent values, this 6, 11, this root of 121 minus 36, this root of 85. So this 10 inverse of root of 85 by 6. So we can check angle from x and y are these, and these are not matching with any of the values. So we can write none of given options is correct in this situation. So that's what we can say about this question. None of the option is correct over here. Thank you, Boji. So student, in this question of kinetic theory, it is asking the value of mean free path for oxygen molecules, temperature, pressure and molecular diameter is given. So we'll directly make use of the formula of mean free path that is given as lambda m is equals to kt divided by root 2 pi d square p. So if we numerically substitute the value, this will give us the result 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23. Temperature is 300 Kelvin divided by this 1.414 into 3.14 and d square here will be 0.09 into 10 to the power minus 18 multiplied by pressure can be written as 1.01 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So numerically, I'm leaving this calculation to you. It gives you 102.6 nanometer. So the closest match to this question would be answer option D. Thank you, Boji. So student, this is a simple question of motional EMF where magnetic field in the region is given as a function of x and z direction, and a square loop of side D is placed with the edges along x and y axis, and the loop is moved with a constant velocity of v naught I cap, and we are required to calculate the EMF induced in the loop. So EMF induced in loop will only be in this edge, because left edge here we can say magnetic field is zero. And at this edge, magnetic field is given as B naught D by A, because at this point, X is equals to D. So directly we can write as a magnetic field is out is an outward direction. By right hand palm rule, we can see here this edge will be positive, this will be negative, and EMF induced we can write B V naught D, and the magnitude of magnetic field we can write B naught D by A multiplied by V naught D. So this B naught V naught D square by A. That matches with answer option A. So direct question is there, which we can solve and proceed. Thank you, Poji. So students, in this question of radioactivity, it is asking the time interval between 33% decay and 67% decay, and half-life of substances given as 20 minutes. So here we can directly make use of radioactive decay law. So by radioactive decay law, we can write initially if 67% decay is analyzed, so we can write 2 N0 by 3 is equals to N0. 2 to power minus T1 by 20. If T1 is the time in which 67% is left over, yani 33% yani decay ho chuka hai. And this is at time T1, and then further we can write at time T2. Agar 67% decay ho gaya, to left over will be N0 by 3. So we can write it N0 2 to power minus T2 by 20. Now we divide these values, we can directly write if there's 1, there's 2, so 1 by 2 will result, left hand side it is 2 and not gets cancelled out, this 2 to power, this is 1 by 20, and this will be T2 minus T1. So here you can see as this 2 to power 1, this gives us T2 minus T1 is equals to 20 minutes. So directly we can take up answer option D to be the correct one in this case. Thank you, Poji. So student, there's a question from viscosity, and here it is saying what will be the nature of flow of water from a circular tap when its flow rate increased from 0.18 liter per minute to 0.48 liter per minute, and the radius of tap and viscosity of water are given, density is also given. So we just need to check whether the flow will be laminar or unsteady turbulent. So to check it, we need to only calculate the value of Reynolds number. If it is less than 2000, it will be steady. If it is more than 2000, it will change to turbulent. So here in solution, we can write Reynolds number is given as R is equals to rho V D by eta. This is what we calculate. Here rho and eta are given, V D we can calculate. So here V D you can calculate directly. V D can be calculated as we can write V multiplied by pi D square by 4. Is the flow rate this given as 0.18 liter means into 10 to power minus 3 meter cube divided by 60. So this will be the flow rate. So this will be meter cube per second. So numerically we can calculate the value of VD here. This gives you 0.18 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by 4 divided by pi is 3.14 into 60 multiplied by 1D you can put over here, this 0.5 into 10 to power minus 2. So this is VD. Reynolds number can be correspondingly calculated. Initially Reynolds number will be rho VD by eta. So rho is given as 10 to power 3. Eta is given as 10 to power minus 3. And VD is calculated over here. This 0.18 into 10 to power minus 3 into 4 divided by this 3.14 into 16 into 0.005. Numerical calculation in this paper was little bit on higher side. If you calculate, this comes out to be approximately 760. And finally, Reynolds number, you can calculate, this becomes 3 times initial because flow rate is changing to 3 times. So this is approximately 76 multiplied by 3. You take this 2280 approx. So this going turbulent is steady. And further, you can write it unsteady or turbulent. So in this case, answer option will choose as option B, the correct answer for this question. Thank you, Boji. So student, in this question, it is saying in order to determine the Young modulus of a wire of radius 0.2 centimeter, which is measured with a least count 0.001, and length 1 meter, which is having least count of its measurement instrument is having least count 1 mm, and weight of mass 1 kg with a least count of 1 gram. And here it is also given that elongation in wire is 0.5 centimeter with the an error of 0.001 centimeter. And we are required to calculate the fractional error in measurement of Young modulus. So we can first write Young's modulus is given as, here we can write Young modulus, we write weight upon pi r square divided by x upon L. So fractional error in measurement of y can be given as dy by y. The maximum value will be dw by w plus, as r square is there, this 2 dr by r plus dx by x plus it is dl by l. So substituting the values, the dw is 1 gram and w is 1. So this 0.001 by 1 plus twice of dr given here is wire is of radius 0.2 and least count is 0.001 divided by 0.2 plus dx is 0.5 and least count is 0.001. So the 0.001 divided by 0.5. As units are same, I am ignoring units here. The L is 1 mm and length is 1 meter. So this 0.001 by 1. So simplifying, calculating the values, this is giving us 0.014. So this is dy by y. So if we calculate the percentage error, so this can be multiplied with 100. This gives us 1.4%. That matches with answer option C in this case. Thank you, Boji. So student, next is a question of converging lens from re-optics, but it is a direct theoretical question where it says refractive index of a lens is 1.4. And now it is asking what will be the focal length of the lens if it is placed in a medium of same refractive index. So we know very well in case of, we can write by lens maker formula, in case of a lens is placed in the medium of same focal length, so this becomes 1 by f is equals to, here we can write mu of lens by mu of medium minus 1 multiplied by 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So here this part is becoming 1, so this coming out to be 0 implies focal length becomes infinite. Directly you can write the answer, although I have explained, but just by reading you can mark answer option A, because if a refractive index of lens material same as that of medium light rays will not be refracted at all, so focal length will become infinite. Thank you, Poji. So student, in this question it says a resistance develops 500 joule of thermal energy 20 second when a current of 1.5 ampere is passed through it. It says if the current increase from 1.5 to 3, that means it is doubled. So what will be the new energy developed? We know very well that energy developed is directly proportional to I square if current get doubled. So this is made 2 times, so this will be made 4 times. This implies new energy will be 4 multiplied by 500, that is 2000 joule. The quotient belongs to the fundamental of grade 10. So your answer option A will be chosen in this case. Thank you, Boji. So student, in this question it says we are required to find the surface charge density at the intersection point x equals to 3 meter plane and x axis in the region of uniform line charge of 8 nanocoulomb per meter lying along z axis. So agar surface charge density nikalne, to we need to consider this to be a conducting plane, then only we can calculate this. So here in solution, if there is a line charge having lambda coulomb per meter surface charge density, then at a distance x here, if we place a conducting plane, so inside conductor field should be zero. So due to this lambda, electric field will be lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught x, and due to this charge which is induced over here, if it is sigma here, it should be sigma by epsilon naught. So for E inside conductor to be equals to zero, sigma by epsilon naught should be equals to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught x. Here epsilon naught gets cancelled out. Substituting the values, this 8 nanocoulomb per meter divided by 2 into 3.14 multiplied by x is 3. Simplifying, this gives 0.424 nanocoulomb per meter square. That matches with answer option A in this question. Thank you, Boji. So student, in this question we are given with a logic circuit and we are required to check which logic gate equivalent to this logic circuit. So here we have directly boolean equation like that. If this is A or B, hai, so here we are getting A bar and P bar. And at this point, we are getting A bar dot B bar whole bar. And finally, we are coming out. The final output we are getting here is, you can write Y is equals to A bar dot B bar only. And this can be written as A plus B whole bar. So this is the boolean expression for a NOR gate. So in this question, final correct answer we can directly choose as answer option D. Quite a direct question. Poji, aage bade. Thank you, Poji. So student, yahan pe humare paas do statements is question mein given hai. The very first is a cyclist is moving on an unbanked road with a speed of 7 kph and it takes a sharp circular turn along the path of radius 2 meter without reducing the speed. A static friction be given hai. Cyclist does not slip and pass the curve. We can check this. सॉल्यूशन में हम ये देख सकते हैं जो सेफ स्पीड होती है फॉर सर्कुलर टर्न दिस इक्वल्स टू रूट ऑफ म्यू आरजी. इफ वी कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू, म्यू इज गिवन एज 0.2, रेडियस इज 2 जी, वी कैन टेक एज 10. सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 2 मीटर्स पर सेकंड. और साइक्लिस्ट की जो स्पीड दी हुई है दैट इज 7 kph, दैट इज 7 × 5/18, दिस 35/18, सो दिस सर्टनली लेस देन 2 meters per second. This implies it will be safe turning, so we can write a statement 1 as correct. Now statement 2 अपन देखते हैं, वहाँ पे given if the road is banked at an angle 45 degree, then it says cyclist can cross the curve of 2 meter radius with the speed 18.5 kph without slipping. So we can write for banked road, अगर safe turning speed की बात करेंगे, तो this given as root of higher side we check up because 18.5 multiplied by 5/18. Here you can see cyclist speed is somewhere around 5.1 meters per second. Pehle likh lete hain. So this is approximately this 18.5 into 5/18. So yeah, hamare paas 5.1 meters per second. So certainly it is higher than 2. So higher speed limit we need to check safe turning speed for higher limit. So higher limit is given as root of RG multiplied by we write as sine theta plus mu cos theta divided by cos theta minus mu sine theta. I hope you can recall this, already we have derived in concept videos. So the values we need to substitute, so this gives root of r is 2, g we take as 10, so this is 1/√2 gets cancelled out because yahan pe theta angle 45 degree given hai. So here it will be 1 plus mu is 1.2 divided by 1 minus mu is 0.8. So here this 4 and this is 3, so this comes out to be root 30 meters per second. That is approximately 5.45 meters per second. So you can see again this is less. That means in this case we can directly write a statement true is also correct. So in this case I will choose the answer option C for this question. That's the correct answer for this question. Thank you, Boji. So students, in this question it says half-life of gold is 2.7 days and the activity of 1.5 milligram of gold, we are required to calculate its atomic weight is this. So it's simply a calculation based question. So here activity can be simply given as lambda, and value of lambda we can write as ln 2 by half-life, this 0.693 divided by 2.7 into 86400. These are number of seconds in a day. So multiplied by number of atoms, we can calculate this 1.5 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by Avogadro number is 6 into 10 to power 23 divided by atomic weight of gold is 198 gram, because here mass also we have taken in grams. So we just need to calculate, and we need to calculate the activity in curie. So we divide it by 3.7 into 10 to power 10. These are the disintegrations per second in one curie. So it's just a calculation part. I'm leaving it to you on calculating. This gives approximately 365 curie. So the closest match to this, we can write closest match is the possible answer option C. That's what we need to choose as answer to this question. Thank you, Boji. Students, in this question, it's a theoretical based question where it says red light differs from blue lights as they have. So agar frequency wavelength ki baat karein, to dono light ki vacuum mein sirf speed same hoti hai. And we know well, in case of frequency, we write it C by lambda. So both frequency and wavelength are different for red and blue lights. That's what we need to write. So answer option here we consider as option D. So kuch bhi nahi karna, just theoretical hai. Within 5 or 10 seconds you can mark this question and proceed. Poji, next. Thank you, Poji. So in this question it simply says a charge Q is moving dl distance in the magnetic field. We are going to find the work done by field, so we don't need to even check. Directly we can write answer here is B, because magnetic force, we can write magnetic force is always perpendicular to motion of charge. So agar magnetic force perpendicular hoga, to it does not do any work. So directly answer mark karo, aage badho. Thank you, Boji. Students, yahan pe main transformer circuit given hai, in which it is asking which type of transformer it is. So यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं primary voltage is given to us as 220 volt, और secondary voltage देखेंगे तो directly power at secondary divided by current in secondary से निकाल सकते हैं. So the 60 watt divided by secondary coil current is 0.11. is equals to 6000 by 11 volt, which is approximately is 545.45 volt. Here you can see secondary voltage is more than primary voltage. This implies this is a step up transformer. So directly you can choose answer option D in this question. That's it. Thank you, Boji. Students, in this question it says a solid disk of radius A and mass M rolls down without a slipping down an inclined plane of angle theta. और प्योर रोलिंग में हम अगर एक्सेलरेशन की बात करें तो वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट फॉर प्योर रोलिंग ऑन इंक्लाइंड प्लेन एक्सेलरेशन वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट एज जी साइन थीटा डिवाइडेड बाय 1 प्लस के स्क्वायर बाय आर स्क्वायर. दिस इज ऑलरेडी व्हाट वी हैव डिराइव्ड इन कॉन्सेप्ट वीडियोस वेयर के बाय आर कैन बी रिटन एज 1 बाय रूट 2 फॉर डिस्क. So here, if we substitute the values, this g sine theta divided by 1 plus 1 by 2, that is equals to 2g sine theta by 3. If we compare it with 2g sine theta by b, this gives us the value of b is equals to 3. That's the answer to this question. Thank you, Boji. So student, yahan pe hame torque ki calculation karni hai, jisme force given hai aur point given hai, jahan pe force lag raha hai, which is the intersection point of x equals to 2 plane and x axis. Aur torque calculation jis point ke about karni hai, that is also given. So yahan pe if we calculate the force application point, to ye hamare paas given hai r1 vector is 2i cap aur torque point jo given hai r2 vector, jis point ke about torque ki calculation karni hai, this 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap और force vector हमें given है 4i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. So torque अगर यहाँ calculate करेंगे तो torque vector होता है r cross f और इस point के about torque निकालना है तो we'll take r2 minus r1 vector cross product with force. इसको reverse भी कर दो फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा because negative value आ जाएगी, but यहाँ पे अगर हम calculation करें so this gives 3j cap plus 4k cap. We take cross product with 4i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. So simply cross product calculation. J cross I in this case will be minus k. So this will be, you can take 4 multiplied by 3, 12. And no other value will be obtained. J cross J will be 0. So this will be, we are getting minus 12k cap. And for 3 cross 4, j cross k will be giving us 12 i cap. So this will be plus 12 i cap. And for this 4k cap, you can see what we are getting. 4k cap cross 4 i cap will be plus 16 j cap. And 4 cross 3, this will be 12 k cross j will be minus I. So this will be minus 12 i cap. That gets cancelled out. So value we are getting is 16 j cap minus 12 k cap. So magnitude of torque, if we calculate this, root of 256 plus 144, this equals to 20 newton meter. That's the answer to this question. Thank you, Poji. So once this is again a simple question of a swimmer swimming in a flowing river where the swimmer velocity is given as 12 kph and the river current velocity is 6 kph. And we need to calculate the direction with respect to the flow of river so that the swimmer will reach the point directly opposite to the starting point on one bank. So agar ye river hai, this flowing with the velocity UF equals to 6 kilometers per hour. Aur agar swimmer ko point A se B pe jana hai, to swimmer has to swim in backward direction with the velocity VS. VS is given to us as 12 kph. And when UF is added to it, the resulting velocity should be towards B. So directly opposite पहुंचने के लिए theta angle to the line AB he has to travel, where sin theta we can write as UF by V as the 6 by 12 is 1 by 2. So theta यहाँ पे आ गया 30 degree. So with the direction of river flow, the total angle is 90 degree plus 30 degree. So total angle with respect to UF vector is 120 degree at which he has to swim. That's the answer to this question. So very fundamental direct question. Theoretically, you have seen concept video. Mein ye ka yehi solved example I've already taken. Poji, next. Thank you, Poji. So in this question, it says a 2 kg body moves under the influence of a force and initially it was at rest at origin. और आफ्टर 4 सेकंड इसके नए कोऑर्डिनेट गिवन है और हमको वाई कोऑर्डिनेट कैलकुलेट करना है, तो डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन है, कुछ करना ही नहीं। दिस अ वेरी फंडामेंटल क्वेश्चन ऑफ द लेवल ऑफ क्लास 9th ओनली। सो अगर एक्सेलरेशन एंड वाई डायरेक्शन निकालें, दिस 3/2 इज 1.5 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर। सो डिस्प्लेसमेंट इन 4 सेकंड इफ वी कैलकुलेट, तो वाई कैन बी रिटन एज हाफ ए वाई टी स्क्वायर। सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी हाफ इंटू 1.5 इंटू 16, दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 8 multiplied by 1.5, 12 meter, that's the value of B. So that's the answer to this question. Same for X and Z, you, if you wish, you can verify also. Thank you, Boji. Students, in this question, a parallel plate capacitor given hai, jiski capacitance nikalni hai, half width dielectric dali hui hai, aur puri width mein half empty hai. और रिजल्ट भी हमको कैपेसिटेंस एप्सिलॉन नॉट के टर्म्स में निकालना है, डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट गिवन है। सो डायरेक्टली वी कैन मेक यूज ऑफ द फॉर्मूला फॉर पार्टली फिल्ड डायलेक्ट्रिक कैपेसिटर। दिस गिवन एज एप्सिलॉन नॉट ए डिवाइडेड बाय डी बाय 2 प्लस डी बाय 2 के, दैट्स व्हाट वी नीड टू यूज। सो ए इज गिवन एज 2, सो दिस 2 एप्सिलॉन नॉट डिवाइडेड बाय डी इज गिवन एज 1 मीटर। सो दिस 1/2 प्लस 1/2 इनटू 3.2, so this gives us 4 epsilon naught, or even 4 multiplied by 3.2, so this is 12.8 epsilon naught divided by 3.2 plus 1 is 4.2, so this comes out to be approximately 3.05 epsilon naught. So yahan pe humko epsilon naught ka coefficient nikalna hai, to answer in nearest integer we choose as 3. Thank you, Poji. Students, this question mein we are given that a closed organ pipe of length L and an open argon pipe contain gases of densities rho 1 and rho 2. And their compressibilities are equal in both the pipe. Compressibility, I hope you can recall, that is gamma P, reciprocal of gamma P. So gamma P is same for the two. And they are vibrating in their first overtone with the same frequency. So humko open pipe ki length nikalni hai aur compare karke X calculate karna hai. So in solution mein we can write frequency for closed pipe is given to be same as that of open pipe. So closed key first overtone frequency we can write thrice of V1/4L is equals to, for open pipe it is twice of V2/2L. LO jo humko calculate karna length of open pipe. So yahan pe I can put the value 3/4L multiplied by this root of gamma P by rho 1, this is equals to 1/LO root of gamma P by rho 2. So, yahan se length of open pipe nikal jayega 4L/3 times root of rho 1 by rho 2. If you compare it with XL/3 root of rho 1 by rho 2, this is giving us the value of X is equals to 4. So, that's the answer to this question. Thank you, Boji. Students, again a very fundamental question from the level of grade 10. It says energy dissipated by a resistor is 10 millijoule in 1 second when an electric current of 2 milliampere flows through it, and we need to calculate the resistance. So directly hum energy ki value likh sakte hai, I square RT. Energy is 10 into 10 to power minus 3. I square is 2 into 10 to power minus 3 whole square into RT is 1 second. So R ka value directly we are getting this 10 into 10 to power 3/4, this 2500 ohms. That's the answer to the question, a very direct and fundamental question. Thank you, Boji. Students, again a direct question where it says if one wants to remove all the mass of R to infinity in order to break it up completely, then the amount of energy that's need to be supplied will be this. So basically yahan pe hume calculate karni hai self energy of earth or a solid sphere. Self energy of a solid sphere is the amount of energy required to be given to a solid sphere to break its particle apart to infinity. So that's a direct value of the self energy we have studied in theory, this minus 3/5 gm square by r. So energy to be supplied or work will be negative of this, which is 3/5 gm square by r. So value of x directly we can say the value we are getting is 3. If you want to capture the derivation of this value, that already I've taken up in theory. In electrostatics also we have derived the same the self energy of a uniformly charged conducting sphere. The same value is valid for gravitation also. Go through the derivation concept videos, kyunki ye cheeze direct short notes mein yaad rakhni thi aur yahan pe we are getting the result. Thank you, Poji. Students, this question mein we are given that a deviation of 2 degrees produced in the yellow ray when prism of crown and flint glass are achromatically combined. So achromatic combination mein we know delta 1 minus delta 2 will be the total deviation. और डिस्पर्सिव पावर ऑफ क्राउन एंड फ्लिंट ग्लास आर ऑल्सो गिवन टू अस, और रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स भी गिवन है. हमें निकालना है रिफ्रैक्टिंग एंगल फॉर क्राउन ग्लास प्रिज्म. सो यहाँ पे हम फर्स्ट डायरेक्टली वी कैन राइट डेल्टा 1 माइनस डेल्टा 2 इज गिवन अस 2 डिग्री एंड वी यूज ओमेगा 1 डेल्टा 1 इक्वल्स टू ओमेगा 2 डेल्टा 2. दिस फॉर अक्रोमेटिक कॉम्बिनेशन बिकॉज इन दिस केस टोटल dispersion here is coming out to be zero. So this is one of the condition for the same. So we can write delta 1 minus delta 2. You can write omega 1 delta 1 by omega 2 is equals to 2 degree. This is giving us the value of delta 1 as 2 into 0.03 by 0.01. This is 6 degree. And we know this is written as A multiplied by mu 1 minus 1. So yahan pe prism angle aata hai 6 degree divided by 1.5 minus 1. This is 12 degree. That's the answer to this question. Thank you, Poji. Students, in this question, it says an ideal heat engine, obviously, which works on a Carnot cycle. The temperature of source is 127 degrees centigrade. And in order to have 60% efficiency, we need to calculate the temperature of sink. So directly, we use kar sakte hain. Efficiency is given as 1 minus T2 by T1. For efficiency 0.6 linear, this 1 minus T2. Temperature of sink, humko calculate karna hai. Temperature of source is 127, that is 400 Kelvin. सो ये हमारे पास टी सिंक निकल के आ जाता है. दिस 1 माइनस 0.6 इज 0.4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 400. दिस 160 केल्विन दैट इज इक्वल्स टू 113 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. वी जस्ट सबट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम 273 केल्विन. सो दिस शुड बी द आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन.